Good morning, welcome back to another vlog style video. In the last one we did my 5-year plan, gave you an insight of to my plan in the next 5 to 7 years. So I hope you enjoyed that. If you haven't already, go back, watch that one, then come back to this one and go from there. So it's Monday the 13th of September. Today is 5:30. We're getting to the gym for 6, training push today. Starting the week strong, like I always like to do. Wanted to touch on peri-workout nutrition this morning. Give you a bit of an insight into what I'm doing around training. I might have touched on it in a different video, but the plan has kind of changed in terms of weights of food, food being added and stuff like that. So I'll give you an insight into that. So pre-workout, obviously it's 5:30 now. I don't eat before I train. My last meal that goes in is the night before at about 8 o'clock. So I have my oats then. 125 gram of oats, 2 scoops of whey, isolate, 25 gram of peanut butter, 25 and 20 gram of jam. So that goes in before bed. I go to bed, I wake up, hydrate. And then pre-workout is a monster, white monster, every day. That is just enough caffeine for me to start the session, feel a bit more awake as we're training early. So that goes in. Then intra workout nutrition, I will have 100 grams, it is now 100 grams of carbs, 10 grams of essential amino acids, and 5 grams of creatine. That's my intra, so I get sipped on throughout the session usually. Like to finish that by the end of the session, and then post workout, which it usually goes in about 30 minutes, sometimes straight away, but is 150 grams of Cocoa Pops, which is the highest it's been. So pushing food up at the moment, and then 1 scoop of whey iso. Pretty simple. This morning weighed in at 120.6 kilo. So weight starting to go up again. We had that little week where we had a few fluctuations in weight, went down to 117 just because of stresses in work and doing a few more steps in work. So we've had to manipulate the nutrition. Well, Luke has, he's added more food in, added 2 refeeds a week, which I put on my rest days. That was yesterday. So obviously with more calories yesterday, bit of weight gain this morning, which is probably a bit of water retention and stuff like that. I just made my 3 meals. So I make 3 meals in the morning for the next day. The reason I just do 3 is because the other 3, so we have 6 in total, the other 3 are just easy to prepare and take less time. This takes about 12, 15 minutes to do. So we've got beef and rice, simple. We've got cod fillets and rice, and then this is the new one, 200 gram of turkey mince, pretty plain. But with this meal I will add in 3 wholemeal pita breads, and 40 gram of cheese. Yeah, 40 gram of cheese in the diet. So I was excited about that. Really good actually. Today, because I'm not in work, I will get out the toasty press and press them so the cheese melted. Usually I just have my meals cold, which I'm used to now, which is not too bad, but that's it. Anyway, gonna leave now, otherwise I will be late. As I said, training push today, looking forward to it. Got a big numbers to hit. Smith incline press, which is my big one, reverse banded, first movement in. So we're looking forward to that. But yeah, looking forward to good sessions today. I had good sleep last night. Yeah, so we'll crack on. I'll get some footage as usual, show you the session. Numbers has changed. It's still just progressing, following progressive overload. I'm working up from there, so enjoy. Thanks, guys.
Ghost.
So back home from push, very good session. Incline Smith, first movement in. Got up to some good weight for a set of six. That is a improvement from last week. A little 1.25 aside, I think, increase. So we got six on that. So next week we can move up weights again and see what I get. Try and go for six again.
The one movement that I wanted to hit today was the Cybex incline plate loaded press, which as you saw, I got 6 on that. So very, very happy with that set. Been chasing that now for the last 2 weeks. The last 2 weeks got 5. And just been stuck on 5. So today I said to myself, you know, got to get 6 or we're going to have to bring the weight down and go for a higher rep range. So we got 6 today. We made it happen. Next week in the logbook, I will add on a rep, try and get a +1 or +2, and see where we go from there. So all around, great session, good accessory movements, progressed on them. So very happy with that. Post-workout, went in, we had the 150 grams of Cocoa Pops, scoop of whey isolate, and yeah, that's my post-workout, which at the moment goes in straight away, straight after my session. Because usually I'm rushing to get to work for 10. So I've got to fit, you know, 2 meals in before I go to work. So we have that now, which I had before I left the gym. Then we'll go in now, have a shower and get meal one in, which will be eggs. What is it? 4 egg white, 2 yolk, 2 bacon medallions and a bagel with 20 gram of ketchup or brown sauce. Don't know, depends on my mood when I'm there. But yeah, I think I'm gonna leave this video here. I wanna keep these training ones quite short because I know a lot of people don't wanna watch a 20, 30 minute video at the moment. So we'll keep it quite short. In other news, I think, you know, check in tomorrow. I was 120, I think I said this morning, I can't remember, but I was 120.6 this morning. Calories were high yesterday, close to 5,000. A lot of carbs using the GDA, glucose disposal agent, in most of my meals yesterday, just to shuttle them carbs around and get them to the right places. But no, digestion was good. Last meal, slight bit of bloating, but that was because I had to chug a load of water before bed. With oats, doesn't really go down well if you have a lot of water and oats. So that was a bit my fault on my end. But fueled the session very nicely. I felt fucking strong this morning. Good sleep. Yeah, just an all-round good Monday session. Ready for legs tomorrow. As I said, checking tomorrow, so see what weight is. Another day on, I think it's 4,800 calories today, which is still, you know, it's still not quite low, but obviously we're pushing weight up now. But the heaviest we got to last year when we were pushing weight was 123, which I think is about 270, just over 270. So, you know, I think we're going to surpass that this time. I'm a lot leaner, a lot better condition. Obviously more muscle has been put on since then, and the more muscle you have, the more calories that need to take to supply the energy to keep the muscle full of energy. So yeah, I think we're gonna push calories up again, maybe not next week because weight's gone up this week. We'll see what weight is like next week, but that's the kind of, we're going in that direction, you know, in everything. Training, nutrition, recovery as well. I'll be prioritizing recovery a lot this week, making sure my sleep is on point. Where the last week, I think, you know, it wasn't great. You know, I'm trying to make my sleep as good as possible at the moment, prioritize it. It's slightly out of my control because of work. So, you know, depending on what time I get home, usually it's about 10:30, 11:00. Weekends, 10:30. So getting to bed about 10:30, 11:00, 12:00. You know, it's not great getting up at 4:45. You know, sleep at the moment is all right. I can deal with it. You know, I've done, 3 weeks of these kind of hours, and I feel all right. You know, on my rest days, I make sure I'm recovering, resting as much as possible, getting the most sleep I can get. and all around, you know, just trying to prioritize that sleep when I can, because that's what is going to give me some great sessions. And we need good sleep for great sessions and to grow. You know, we don't grow in the gym, we don't grow when we're walking around in the day. Really, you grow when you sleep, and you know, that's where the most tissue is going to be made. You know, we break down muscle in the gym and then repair it and grow it through the day and into the night. So that sleep period, very important for bodybuilders, and any people who are training. I'm trying to take their training to next level. So, but yeah, that's today pretty much. You know, my day is pretty much exactly the same. So apologies if these videos are similar. They will be, because my day is pretty much exactly the same. So I do the same thing every day. I could, you know, switch it up and do some exciting stuff, which I know a lot of people on YouTube do, and, you know, they try and be outside the box. And but I want to be as real as possible. You know, this is actually how my mornings and my days go every single day. You know, if I was to try and do something different, which I could easily, you know, if I wanted to do something exciting, I could go and do it, but that wouldn't be true to me. It's not what I'm doing. You know, every morning I get up, you know, 4:45, I go downstairs, I make my meals for the next day, I prepare myself for the gym, I get my supplements ready, take my morning supplements, drive to the gym, train for 2 hours till 6 till 8, have my intra, get back in the car, have my post-workout meal, come home, shower, eat another meal, and go to work and get the next 4 meals in for the rest of the day. And then I'm home by, you know, quite late, you know, 12-hour shifts. So that's the reality of what I'm doing. You know, I don't want to be this fancy YouTuber, which, you know, brings you mad videos every week. And I'm just trying to be as real as possible, and this is what I do, and this is what I'm doing. I'm just going to change myself for YouTube. There's a man mowing the lawn. But yeah, try and keep it, you know, as real as possible. So apologies if you're getting bored of these videos, but this is just how it is at the moment. And with the time I've got, this is what we're doing. So, you know, obviously not every video is going to be the same. As the program changes, I'll be able to update you on different things. Like this week, we're going into a rest pause week, so we're going to get rest pause sets into the session. I haven't had the program over for that yet, so today was just a normal session. But rest pause should be going in today or tomorrow. We'll be utilizing that this week. And obviously the up in food has happened. So, you know, there's changes every week, subtle changes every week to either diet or training or things like that, you know. So there are changes going on. But, you know, bodybuilding is very monotonous. It's very... If you want to be good, you've got to be consistent over a period of time, a long period of time. And that's why I pride myself on being consistent and being able to do the same every day, which I love. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying I don't enjoy it. I freaking enjoy it, you know. I love doing the same thing every day. I love prepping my meals. I love the challenge of eating those high calorie meals and... you know, lifting the heavy weights, I enjoy it. So that's not me complaining in any way at all. But yeah, every day is the same. And I'm just trying to document that and show you what it is that I'm doing and what I'm trying to achieve, which you would have heard in the last video. And we're just a day closer to that now, you know. Every day we're a day closer to whatever, you know, winning a show, the pro card, which is on my list to get. Obviously pro show, you know, I do want to take this all the way and as far as I can take it. Obviously putting health first, but you know, I do want to take this as far as I can take it, and you know, get to the elite level and stand with the big boys and stand with the elite bodybuilders in the industry. You know, stand next to them, compare myself to them, see what I can improve. You know, because we're always about improving and progressing. You know, and I just want to, you know, showcase what I've been working on, you know, for the last seven years. Well, whenever I compete, it'll be 7, 8, 9, last 10 years, whatever. You know, I want to, as I said, take this all the way, take this as far as I can. I just want to be real with you and keep you updated on every week. Changes that are being made to training, nutrition, recovery, and everything. So, waffled on enough, said what I need to say. So I think we'll leave it there. Thank you for watching if you got to the end of this video. Make sure you go back and watch the last videos. Last one was the 5-year plan, and there's training sessions before that, and day in the life stuff. So don't forget to go and watch that. Hope you enjoyed this video. Obviously there'll be one coming next week, so we'll see you then. But until then, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Cheers, guys.